Hare Krishna. Covering our tracks thoroughly is not intelligence. Choosing our tracks thoughtfully is. Some people do something wrong and then they very carefully cover their tracks so that nobody can detect what wrong they have done. And they think, I'm so clever, I got away with it. They think that doing something wrong is not the problem, getting caught is the problem. However, this is a very superficial and self-destructive use of the intelligence. Yes, we may not get caught immediately for our wrongs, but actually speaking, we will be caught by our wrongs. That means any action that we do, it creates an impression within our mind. And then that impression will lead to the proposition to repeat those actions. And the more deep-rooted the impressions, the more forceful the proposition. And that's how we can get captivated, we can get deceived. And if we do not want to do this, we need to focus on moving toward elevating ourselves properly. And that means not using our intelligence to cover our tracks thoroughly, but to choose our tracks thoughtfully. If you understand that the consequence of indulgence is not separate from indulgence, it is inbuilt in indulgence. It is concomitant. That means the impression externally we may not be caught, but internally we'll be caught because that impression will become strong. Then we will choose our tracks thoughtfully. We will recognize that each action, however casual, is an unconscious commitment to multiple similar actions in the future. Each time, say, we visit a particular website, that website gets stored in our preferences and we will visit it, we'll be inclined to visit it again. And similarly with everything else in life. So once we understand this, then we don't let our intelligence work against us. Krishna talks about this possibility in the third chapter, 41st verses, when he says that Indriyani mano buddhir asyadhishtanam uchyate etair vimohayatyesha jnanamavritya dehinam. He says that Indriyani mano buddhir, that our senses, our mind, and even our intelligence are occupied by selfish desire, by kama, by lust, and this can make our intelligence work against us. However, if we study scripture and nourish our intelligence properly, then our intelligence will point toward transcendence, not towards indulgence. That's what Krishna talks about in 343 when he says, evam buddhe param buddhva samstabhyatmanam atmana jahi shatrum mahabaho kamarupam durasadam. That with intelligence, situate yourself in transcendence and thus conquer the impulse for self-destruction. So the test of our intelligence is not in how smartly we cover our tracks, but how cautiously we choose our actions, we choose our tracks. Thank you. Hare Krishna.